letting the ball go. Because he was shook by the end of the game. And he don't throw the deep ball too well. If you put Deshaun Watson on that team last night, it'd have been a hell of a game. I don't think your man got what it takes. I'm just saying. I ain't knocking your boys. Because I'm a big-time Deshaun Watson fan. I used to like Kelly Bryant. And I also used to like, I like Deshaun Watson. And my man, he chopping it up with me on Twitter, Taj Boy. Shout out to my man, Sean Boy. He's listening in the background. But I ain't trying to hit, dog. I ain't trying to hit that Oklahoma thing. But that's what I want to talk about. It's funny that this is what I mentioned earlier in the show, yellow journalism. Yellow journalism is when you print cowardice stuff to support your own situation. And why I say yellow journalism is in full effect is this. All I heard last night was this. The homie from Sunshine has another year to grow. He has another year to grow. He has another year to grow. They question him. But this dude has never survived under adversity. Look, I know 334 and a couple of Alabama people going to be mad at me, but if Coach Nick Saban wasn't a dumbass, they would have won. Oh, yeah, number 8 was getting booked. Number 8 was getting booked by Jefferson and Chase last night. But again, that goes to the coaching of your LSU Tigers. I mean, your Clemson Tigers. Dabo and the defensive coordinator was supposed to get number 8 some protection over the top. They kept playing that one bomber safety. They should have been playing 2D. Once you seen Chase cooking, buddy, he's supposed to got coverage. He's supposed to got coverage over the top. Everybody have a bad night. Homeboy might be good in the pros, but he just had the worst night in the history of his life. He might cost himself $4 million after last night. That's all I'm saying. But I really didn't like what the way they was trying to dress up Sunshine and make it seem like he didn't have a horrible night last night. He did. And when I get into this professional section, you will see what I mean. All I heard was, well, good thing he has an opportunity to come back to school next year because he'll be able to redeem himself. He'll be able to redeem himself. Trevor Lawrence, he didn't have such a bad game. Trevor Lawrence did not rise to the occasion, be great. You are right. Trevor Lawrence is not the entire team, but the entire team didn't get shut out in the second half, damn it. Only time they scored is when my man turned the ball over. Trevor Lawrence did not show up. If Sunshine was Marcus Jones from South Central or Cleveland, we would feel the same. No, it ain't got nothing to do with who he is, D-Great. That ain't my get down. Trevor Lawrence didn't show up. Grown man Macaulay Culkin over there at LSU, he showed out, man. Trevor Lawrence didn't show out, bro. I'm just saying. And when I get to the professional segment, you'll see what I'm talking about. Trevor Lawrence does not throw the deep ball well, D-Great. I ain't got no issue with the boy. The boy looked good, but okay. How about this, D-Great? Let me ask you this. When the season started, the conversation with Paul Feinbaum and the rest of the boys on the good old ESPN, they was telling us that Trevor Lawrence was going to be the Heisman Trophy winner, and they was talking about how he should go to the XFL, and they were pretty much taking the Heisman Trophy to his house. It's only one way you lose the Heisman when you playing like that, is you play yourself out of the Heisman race. They were saying that he was pro ready now. They were saying 6 months ago that Trevor Lawrence should sit out and go to the pros next year. Don't risk it. And he played himself out of it. He didn't play as well as Justin Field. He didn't play, what's the boy name at Oklahoma? I can't think of his name. And they were saying that chump couldn't even throw. He didn't play as well as Taylor up there in Wisconsin, the running back. He didn't play as well as Joe Burrow. All I'm saying is, all this jocking of this dude, and he played like a sophomore. HRap, when you get the film on any player, the game changed. Nah, not really. Not really. Because, hey, they had the film on my man Deshaun Watson. They had the film on that bum-ass Tebow. They had the film on Cam. They had the film on, they got the film on a lot of people. You just got to show and prove. I ain't saying Home Alone gonna be cold next year in the league. I don't know. He only got He got 24 stars under his belt, D-Gray. I'm not finna tell you that he gonna do that next year. Because look, here's the get down. Let's not forget that Home Alone had 60 touchdowns and 6 interceptions this year. And he had 18 touchdowns and 7 interceptions last year. Let's not forget that. Because he was playing like that was Trump juice last year. So I ain't finna act like, oh man, Home Alone was killing it. No, Joe Burrow was not killing it. And he got mad and when he broke his hand and Haskins beat him out at Ohio State. So they ain't like this dude, a world beater. But Trevor Lawrence folded last year. Jake Fromm is another one. Jake Fromm don't fold. He may not stand up and show out, but he don't fold. I think Trevor Lawrence folded last night. That's just my personal opinion. And all I heard was, that's true. My man D-Ray said all good. LSU played a better game. They are open, sissy. My girl Tiffany Sports and Hills trying to harass me. She thinks she bad. Call in now, Miss Sports and Hills. They are open. Trying to be all bad. But that go to nothing, sissy. Bam! But no, I ain't dissing him because of who he is. I'm dissing him because he didn't show out. He didn't show out. If you a dude who the whole world is saying, oh man, Blood should be drafted in the first round. He the number one pick. Just like the boy over there at Oregon. Just like Jalen Hurts. All these dudes are big time in high school. Kelly Bryant. Remember, you're a Clemson fan. You're very familiar with Kelly Bryant. He did not show and prove either. Therefore, if you don't show and prove, I got to call you out, man. That's all I'm saying, D-Gray. I ain't mad at you, man. Like I told you, low key on the real low key side of the game. No pun intended, low key. I like Clemson. I'm not a Clemson fan, but I like them because I like their quarterbacks. I like Taj Boyd. I don't like Steve Fuller, bum ass. But I like Taj Boyd. I like, what's his name? Kelly Bryant. Of course, I like Deshaun Watson. Trevor Lawrence ain't living up to their stature. Remember, they set Kelly Bryant, undefeated Kelly Bryant, down with Trevor Lawrence. If you get benched, you need to be kicking ass through perpetuity. You should never have an off game, especially the biggest game of your life. But, I mean, he is a sophomore. He's an authentic sophomore. He was the number two player in the year. Now the delusional Cowboy fans are in the building. D-Gray has done it. I got to go ahead and give you this right now. Because you know them Cowboys ain't going to no Super Bowl next year. Go ahead on with that nonsense, man. Come on, D-Gray. You know better than that. You know better than that. Even though I'm rooting for Dak Prescott. You know I'm a big-time Dak Prescott fan. And I noticed Tiffany Sports and Hills ain't called. She was talking all that bad stuff a second ago. She still ain't called. She ain't called. Because she know. We ain't talking about no damn track over here. This is nighttime. This ain't T. Rocker show. We ain't talking no track. You better be on here talking about them damn Ravens you call this show. But on the serious side, D-Gray, I ain't dissing your boy. Vegas Raiders? Oh, yeah. Phone ain't working. Let me, you know what? I don't know what you're talking about, Jesus. Let me see something. You're just doing this because you're black. Because I'm finna test my own phone. It's working for me. It just worked for me. I called me and it rang. I got you blocked, probably. What's your number? You probably blocked. Because I see you got a Ravens hat on your avatar. Go ahead on. No, call for real on the real side, Tiff. Call in, please. Because I just tested it and it worked. Answer your damn phone. Hey, man, I called myself and it worked. I don't know what y'all problem is. 773-797-2409. It ring when I call. It's because I'm black. Y'all sweating me because I'm black. That's all it is. The white man sent y'all up here to bother me. But back to what I was saying, man. It was a great game last night for a little while. Let me see. I think I got D-Gray's phone number. And I got Tiffany Sports and Hill's phone number around here somewhere. I'll find your number. I'm going to call you. Since y'all trying to diss me. One second. When I find your number, Sports and Hills, I'm calling you. I'm tired of you with all this nonsense. You think you bad. You ain't bad. I know I got D-Grade number. As soon as I get off the phone with D-Grade, I'm calling you, Sports and Hills. Tired of y'all. Oh, there go D-Grade right there. Now I'm calling you, Chunk. I'm calling you, D-Grade. Answer your phone, not D-Grade. D-Grade ain't answering his phone, y'all. He talking crazy to me. Now D-Grade ain't answering. Let me find Tiffany Sports and Hills number. I'll type 90. I knew I typed 90. That's what I said. All right, D-Grade. Dad, I sent you the voicemail. You called my number. You ain't calling show number. It's 09. It's 09. I'm not bad. I'm sorry, Charlie Murphy. Call back. One at a time. I ain't hot tech yet. It's the Late Rent Live Music Studios. Late Rent Live Music Studios, hosted by the end of the bench, is in the Late Rent Live Music Studios. He's one of y'all. Any one of y'all, I dare one of you cowboy or raven lovers to call. Birds and cowboys, any one of y'all, dead bird. I come from a state where it's Indians, where we kill cowboys and we kill birds. We got feathers in our hat. Either one of y'all, I got your number now, Sports Hills. I found it in my phone book. I'm waiting on y'all. You know what? I'm sick of this Sports Hills. She thinks she bad. She thinks she bad. And you talking about no track, you know, Chief let you talk about track and field. This ain't Chief's show. I'm cussing you out. You say, if you say track or field, you get popped. That's all I'm saying, Tiffany. See, Chief nice, I ain't nice. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Tiffany Sports and Hills inaugural get down. Tiffany Sports and Hills is in the building.
Legitimately talked about something you said that had nothing to do with track and field. You tried to diss me because you know I couldn't call in, but it's all good, HRap.
I'm not arguing. But I know you love track and field, and this is a winter sports show.
Track and field is a winter sport. It's called indoor.
No, this is an outdoor winter sports show.
Whatever. So I'm not fooling with you today. I called because you talked about you know, them saying LSU was the greatest team of all time. And so this is where I attribute that to. And I've been saying this for like 2 years. I've been saying this. I can't stand these new class of former NFL, wannabe announcers, you know, the whole go straight to network television into the, you know, the status quo network television shows. I can't stand it because these guys aren't studying. They don't really speak a lot of facts. And it's annoying to me that you can literally discount entire generations of NCAA football players and teams and say the team is the greatest team of all time. Like, stop it. Like,
totally
literally. And it's the same thing that happens with music. I'm sorry?
I totally agree with you.
I didn't hear you.
I said I totally agree with you.
I can't do it. These people, it's like the same thing happens in music. Such and such says this rapper is the greatest of all time. Like, so what happened? Like, are you going to forget the 90s, which is probably the best hit 90s and early 2000s, which is probably the best time in hip-hop history? Like, are you literally going to... Because these kids don't know. Like, they weren't born into the 90s, so they could possibly not know about the U team unless they go on YouTube and watch it. But we all lived through that shit. Excuse my language. We all lived through that. So it's like, come on, man. Like, how can you literally say that this team, they didn't go undefeated. They didn't. We know that the quarterback will go to the Bengals. Well, let's just put that out there. He's going straight to the Bengals. But we don't know where these guys are going to go. And you telling me this is the greatest team because they won the national championship? Like, come on, son. I can't stand it. It's like these guys don't study. They just write down what they hear or what they see. And that's it. That's all they do. They don't do any research. They don't know about anybody other than, you know, the greats, the absolute greats, the Jim Browns. And, you know, come on. Everybody knows who Jim Brown is. So what about everybody in between?
But you know what?
Like, even when you listen